Hello everyone and welcome to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. We're glad you're tuned in. We want to give a shout out to our friends at Southern Oregon PBS, KTVL, KDRV, and the Dove Network. Thank you for hosting us on your station. In the Medford School District, we have one shared vision, and that we believe that all are learning, and learning is for all. And what better place to do that than right here on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
Hi, I'm Kristen Robinson, and I teach kindergarten at Kennedy Elementary here in Medford, Oregon. And today we are going to play some really fun math games. Are you ready to hear what our first standard is? Our first standard says, I can write numbers from 0 to 20. And I love 0 because 0 means there's nothing there, but it's so much fun to write. So I have some index cards. You can pick these up at the local discount store. You can find them in grocery stores. I like to keep them on hand because they're really fun to make flashcards with. So I'm going to move my standard out of the way and let's practice writing our numbers together. I have a purple pen today to write these numbers, and you'll be able to see that I have a hole punched in my cards. Now, if you don't have a hole punched at home, you could have mom or dad or an adult punch a hole with a pair of scissors or anything that they can to kind of put a spot in there to put a string through it or a ring. So let's get started writing our numbers. So I remember my standard said 0 to 20. So I'm going to start with the number 0. So remember, we start at the top for 0 and we make a big loop around and come back up and close it. That's our 0. Now let's practice making a number 1. Now you can make a 1 just going straight down. I really like to make a fancy 1. So see if you can do this like I do at home. So I give it a little tail and then I go down and then I go across because like I said, I really like a fancy 1. Now, if you remember from our math flashcards that we did together, our 2 goes around and down and across. That's number 2. And then we have number 3. And I like to do a straight line at the top of mine because that's how Mrs. Robinson learned. And around the tree for number 3. And number 4 has a lot of straight lines, so it's really fun to write. You go down and across, and then you could give it a nice back line. That's number 4. And I love to make flashcards because anytime I feel like practicing my numbers, I could just pick these up and play with them. I don't even need an adult with me. Now remember, number 5 has a hat, so we're gonna put the hat on and go down and around. There's number 5. And you could put the hat on afterwards if you needed to. Number 6 is a curve and around. And then we close it back up. I like to pretend that it's like a happy face over here. And this is his smile line. After 6 comes number 7. We're going to go across and down. And you could be writing these with a marker or crayons or a pencil, whatever you choose. The best thing about it is that you're practicing. Number 8 is like an S. So you start at the top and you go down and around, but you're not going to stop like an S. You're going to go back up and you get to connect these two. Isn't that a neat number? If it's kind of hard for you to draw an 8 that way, you could make 2 ovals and connect them, but keep practicing. Now number 9. This one again is kind of like a magic C, and then you do the straight line down. And now for one of my favorite numbers, because it actually has 2 numbers in it when we write it. Are you ready? It's a 1, and remember, I like to do a fancy 1, but you could just do a straight line down. It has its little leg, and then we go down, across, and then that 0, that kind of looks like an egg or an oval. That's number 10. Now, if you wanted to, you could play a game where you just looked at your numbers and you said, ooh, a 1 and a 2 makes 12, and that would meet your standard. But I'm going to go ahead and just keep writing my numbers because I really want to practice writing 0 to 20. So I left off on number 10. Let's do number 11. 11 is 2 of my fancy 1s. So I'm going to write a 1. and then another one. And I love that they're next to each other. And remember, when I get to 10, that's introducing me to the teen family. The next number is number 12. Here we go. It's a number 1. And then across and number 2. We're going curve down and across. Now I think I'll show you just a simple one, just so you know what I'm talking about. If you wanted to do a straight line down for number 13, you would say down the line you go. And then remember, my 3s are flat on top because that's the way Mrs. Robinson learned. And she goes around the bottom. It's kind of like a magic C at the bottom. And now 14 is next. I really love writing my numbers because not only does it make me feel really good that I know them, but it's fun and it's creative. Number 14. Are you ready for number 15? Remember to put the hat on him. We're going to go down. Now there's 2 ways you can do this. I showed you how to do it with the hat on top first. We're going to do it the other way so I remember what the hat looks like. You can do a straight line and then you make the magic C that's backwards and put the hat on top. There's number 15. Number 16. I'm going to use my fancy one again because I kind of miss writing it. You give it a little leg and down you go and across. And then my 6 has a beautiful curve, kind of like a big happy face with a magic oval on the bottom. 16, 17. Remember, we're going all the way to 20. So I'm going to do another fancy one. And then I'm going to write my 7, and my 7 goes across and then down. That's 17. Now, 18. I love 18 because it has the S in it. It's like the letter shape, but it's a number. So I'm actually using a skill that I've already learned when I did my alphabet. I'm going to do my straight line down just to remind you that there's 2 different ways. And then I make my S, and then I go back around. And I close her up. And you could even write the words on the bottom of these if you knew how to write them, or you could have mom and dad or an adult help you do that. So after 18 comes 19, getting really close to 20. Let's write a 1. And then a 9 is my magic C once again. We sure love our magic C. It's in so many places in the world. Now number 20. We need a little drum roll. Da, 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 da. 20. It's a 2. So we're going to do up and around and down we go. And then remember, we're putting our bottom on our 2. And then our favorite oval, a 0. I don't like to ever call this an O. I always call it a 0 because that reminds me it means there's nothing there. An O isn't a letter. A 0 is a number. So now that I have my flashcards all done, I'm going to close my pen up because I don't want it to dry up. I like to kind of just put them in a nice stack. And remember I told you I have that hole there? And like I said, you could do anything you wanted with this. You could even use a piece of tape on these to keep them closed, or a binder clip, or a paper clip. The possibilities are really endless. I have my favorite black and white string because we all know Mrs. Robinson loves black and white. If you have an adult with you, make sure they're trimming the string because sharp scissors can be dangerous. And I'm going to put just my string through my holes, and it might be a little tricky. So on this one, I'm going to find the end that's closed up a little more because string likes to separate. And then I stack them one more time to make sure they're even, and then I put it through. And if for some reason I couldn't get it through all of them, I could separate them and do it. I'm going to put this string through, and then I like to make sure, did I get enough string? Yep, I did. And you could tie a knot or a bow. Let's see which one I do today. Let's see, I'll tie a knot first, and I'm going to leave a little wiggle room so I can flip these. I think I'll do a bow, because that way, if I wanted to add more numbers later, I could. Or if I wanted to play a game with my numbers to make the teen numbers, or even 20s, I could. So I'm going to show you how I do that, but first, that's what it looks like if you tie a bow in the corner. So if you were going to play a game with these, say you had a sibling at home or an adult or even a cousin that was staying at your house, you could undo these. And all of a sudden, I have not only my number flashcards, but I can make new numbers from the numbers I wrote. So if I have a 1 and a 0, that would make 10. Oh, what would happen if I change the 0? I could make it 12. I could play all the way, are you ready, to the number 20. Now here's the only tip I'm gonna give you. You only have one number 1. So if you wanted to make an 11, you'd have to have an extra flashcard with the number 1 on it. Now that we've gone through and practiced our numbers, because it's really important to always practice writing your numbers, we're going to make some equations with 10 frames. We are going to do one of my favorite things. We're going to talk about 10 frames. We practiced our numbers, which is very important. Now we have a new standard. Let's read what it says. I can break apart numbers less than or equal to 10 into pairs in more than one way. And to do that, I'm going to use a 10 frame. I'm sure you remember when we were in school, in our classrooms, we use 10 frames all the time. This similar to what you would see on the board in your classroom or even on a piece of paper. Let's count the spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, you might be asking yourself, self, do I remember what a 10 frame's for? I do. It's a visual tool to help me count numbers. So let's just practice using the 10 frame first. And then I'm going to show you how you can make your own 10 frames and how to play games with them at home. So I brought my magnetic numbers because this is usually on my whiteboard in my classroom. Right now it's at my home classroom. And my dots that go on it are red and blue. Let's see how many red dots I have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ooh, I know this is a 10 frame, so I'm going to have to fill it up with some more dots. Let's put some blue in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow, I have 5 and 5. And you know what's really cool? I have 5 fingers on this hand and 5 on this hand, so I always have 10 with me. So it's like having a personal 10 frame, and I can represent that. Remember, represent means show, with a 10 frame and dots. So now that we've had a review of what a 10 frame looks like, are you ready to make one of your own at home? My egg cartons are over here on the side. I'm gonna go ahead and pick them up so you can see one of them. So what I did is I took an egg carton, I cut it, and because I really love that my dots at school are blue and red and it helped me remember 10 frames, I put blue dots inside. But you may be wondering, how do I make my own 10 frame? Let's go over that real quick. Let's move these two that I already made so I can show you. Now in my family, we eat a lot of eggs because I have big boys in my house. I'm gonna open this up and then I'm gonna need scissors. So if you do this, make sure you do it with an adult. I'm gonna cut the lid off and it can get a little messy and dusty because the fiber in the egg carton kind of gets all over the place because it's made of recycled paper. Isn't that cool? You move that aside, and then I don't worry about this part yet because I need to count out my 10, and I don't think I'm gonna have to cut this side. So let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, if you needed to, you could mark that, or you could just kind of cut. I'm gonna show you what I do. I say 1, and you kind of have to cut hard, and if you need to, you could turn it over. 2, I'm on the second one. Oh, 3, I'm getting close because I know half of 10 is 5 because I have 5 fingers on one hand. If you have an X-Acto knife or craft knife and mom and dad are willing to help you, this is a good project for that. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 8's less than 10. I remember that because I have 10 fingers. So I need 2 more. So let's keep cutting. 9, almost there. Oh, did you see? I'm gonna pull it apart just a little bit because look at that. Once you have it cut really well, it starts ripping. I'm gonna pick my cups up because they fell over. And then I'm gonna cut this off And we're going to take off the last two on the end to make sure we only have 10 because it's not called a 12 frame. So let's get rid of these. And once you have your little cup, you could just kind of pull it away. Save these for later because these make really fun math games. So you can see I have a 10 frame I made from an egg carton. Now you could color the inside of these just to help you remember that this is a 10 frame. So let's put this new one aside that we just made, and I'm gonna take out my other two, and I'm gonna show you some really fun things you can do with these. So let's start with one 10 frame, because we know if we have 10 fingers and that equals 10, we're working within 10. And I'm gonna move this one to the side. Now, this is the fun part. I brought some of my beads that I really love, and I brought, are you ready? Dice! I love the sound that dice make. Oh, that's a dice in a bead. Let's get the dice out. Listen, that is the neatest sound. So let's move this over so you can see everything I'm doing. I am going to see if I can fill up my 10 frame, and I'm going to use one dice to do so. So that's a die if you're only using one of a pair. I'm going to move this one aside. Now I'm going to take out some of my beads just so I have them handy and ready. And you could play this game by yourself and write down the numbers afterwards, or you could ask an adult to play with you. The possibilities are endless. Let's start by rolling our die. I got a 3, so I'm going to take 3 of my beads, and I like to touch and count at the same time. That helps me remember the number. 1, 2, 3. Now this makes it fun because I know 3 is less than 10 because I have 10 in my egg carton, or my 10 frame. Now I have, 6. That's a big number. Let's see if I have enough beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need to pull some more glass beads out. Let's get a couple more. 6. Now, you could get tricky and tell yourself, self, I only need one more, so I have to roll a 1. Or you could just roll any number and see what you get. Oh, I got a 6 again, the highest. Should we do it one more time to see if we get a 1? A 6 again? I really must like 6. So I know 6 is going to be more than my available spaces. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put the 1 that I have left in that egg carton. But a good challenge would be to play this with a friend and they couldn't fill that space until you got the exact number. Let's count how many beads we have in our 10 frame. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now I have another really fun math game for us to play with our 10 frame, our dice, and our glass beads. Now we're gonna play some really fun math games with our 10 frames that we made from our egg cartons. You might remember that I colored the insides of mine red and blue, but you could color them any color you wanted to. To play our game, I have some glass beads, I have a marker to write my equations with, I have a pair of dice, and you can get these at any local discount store, and I have some white paper. You could use post-its to write your equations on so you remember them later, or even make some flashcards like we did with our numbers. It's totally up to you. I really enjoy using a pen or a crayon when I write my equations because it makes it more fun to be a little artsy when you're learning. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to roll my dice to see what numbers I need to fill my 10 frame up with. So let's take both of them in our hand and we'll roll them. I'll move them down a little bit so I can see them better. I have a 1 and I have a 3. So I'm going to move my die up here and my other die is going to go down here. And I know that I need to fill my 10 frame up at the top with 1 bead. So let's go ahead and do that. We're gonna put 1 in. And this one, let's count. 1, 2, 3. I need 3 glass beads. 1, 2, 3. Now, looking at this, I can kind of guess how many there are, but I'm gonna write an equation because that gets my brain really working. And I love to write my numbers. So I need a number 1. And remember, when we add, we're using a plus sign. So it looks a lot like a T. It means we're putting things together. So 1 plus, And I had three for my second number. So we're going to write one of my fancy threes that I really like. And then I need to put an equal sign. And the two lines are telling me where one and three are going when they're put together. So let's count together. One, two, three, four. It says four on my die. And when I use my 10 frame to double check myself, one, two, three, four. The answer is four. There we go. I like that. That's fun. Let's do it again. Only this time, let's take our glass beads out because I think it would be more fun to start with other numbers. We're going to take them out and put them aside, and then we're going to roll our die. And I like to kind of mix them up a little bit to make sure that I don't get the same numbers. Here we go. Let's roll them. I got a four, and I think I need to count that to double check. And a little tip I remember is if I turn it sideways, it lines up with the 10 frame. One, two, three, four, five, six. All right, I need to put six glass beads in. One, two, three, four, five. And I know it's a 10 frame, so there's always gonna be five on the top. Six. Wow, there's six. This one. One, two, three, four, four. Okay. One, two, three, four. And I'm gonna show you an extra hint at this part. If you wanted to look exactly like the dice, you could put one, two, and move these. Three, four, and look, it matches your die. So now I need to write some numbers. I remember the first number was number six. So I'm writing six, my nice little oval, and plus, because I'm putting things together, plus. And my second number was four, and I know that because I've counted both the beads and the dots on the die. It's a line down, across, and then we close it all up. And then those equal signs that tell us where the six and the four are going equals, this one's a little bit harder because it's a big number. Let's count all of our numbers together. And remember, we're using our counting on skills. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Oh, the 10 number, I get to write two numbers. Are you ready? The line goes down and the zero comes after the one for the number 10. I love it when I get number 10. So now we're gonna do this one more time. We're gonna make it a little tricky. This is the harder version. We're gonna leave those numbers in and we're gonna roll and see what we're gonna add to them. Here we go. We have a three, and boy, we really love the number six. We already had it once and we had a three once. I feel pretty lucky. Now, I need to add three to this 10 frame. One, two, three, and on this one, I need to add six. Can I do that? It looks like I have extra spaces, but I'm gonna need some more glass beads, so let's take them out. We'll put them on the table and count them into our 10 frame. One, two, three, four, five, six. That is a lot of glass beads in my two 10 frames. Should we count all of them together and see what we come up with? Let's see. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. That's my first number. So I need to write nine on my equation sheet. So nine is the little magic oval, the line down, and the plus because I'm putting them together, not taking them apart. Nine plus, wow, this one's actually really easy for me because if I move it away a little bit and remind myself that it's a 10 frame all by itself, I know there's 10 in there. So I can write 9 plus 10, which is the 1, and the 0. And then the equal sign because it's telling me where 9 and 10 are going. 9 plus 10. Ooh, this is a hard one. I think I better count all of my glass beads. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Whoa, that's a big number. Let's write number one and my nine. And it looks exactly like this one. Remember, it's the magic oval. And we go down 19. So 9 plus 10 equals 19. Wowzer. That was really higher level thinking for us because we only had to add to 10. So I'm going to show you a couple other ideas to do at home when you want to make a 10 frame. Let's move our glass beads away real quick. And actually, we'll move these away too so you can see better. Another idea for your 10 frame is you could use little cups. You would just put them out and you'd want two rows of five, of course. I'm going to just make one row so you see exactly what it looks like. And then you could tape these together if you had some tape. You could use scotch tape or even masking tape. Another idea, which is super mobile and you could take it anywhere, would be to use sticky notes. And you can find these at local discount stores also, or even the grocery store. You would just put them out. One, two, I love to count. Three, four, and five. And I know that I have five fingers on one hand and five on the other, so I need one more row of five, and that would make my 10 frame. And then I could either put dots on these every time I played, or I could just use them as a 10 frame and put objects like my dice, we'll pretend, on top. I've used a 10 frame. Look at that. It's a game all by itself. I hope you had fun playing math games with me today. Remember, everywhere in our world, there's a learning opportunity, and it's always fun. Thank you so much for joining me on Medford Anywhere Learning TV.
Thanks for tuning in to Medford Anywhere Learning TV. Medford School District is a place where all are learning, and learning is for all.
Miss Wells, I miss you a bunch. I hope that this virus stops so I can see you more. Miss you.
I wanted to say hi to Miss Jossie's class and all my friends at Jacksonville, and I miss you. Bye.
Hello, my name is Christian Chavez and I go to KUA Charter School, and I want to give a huge shout out to Miss K Derrickson. She is highly respected with my family and I, and I just wanted to let her know that she's super important to me because she helps me with my education, and I hope she stays safe.
Mr. Smith, I love you.
Thank you, Mrs. Pardo and Mrs. Manili. We miss you and love you.
Bye.
I appreciate Mrs. Valois because she's very hardworking, easy to talk to, and loving and understanding to all her students.
Thank you for all your hard work. This is Beard, I miss you.
Thank you, Miss Shianka, for everything you do. I miss you.
Hi, Mr. Romery and Senora Weinchild. Thank you for all you've done for me.
Hi, Mrs. N. I'm making you a cat because I miss you so much.
I hate being on camera, but I wanted to let my teachers know how much I love them and how much I miss them. Thank you guys for being the best and the greatest. Thank you so much for teaching me.
Hi, my name is Natalia and I go to Logan High School. My teachers are Ms. Southmead and Ms. Lavelle. I want to thank them for always supporting me even through this hard time with coronavirus and doing Zoom calls to teach each other every Wednesday. I just want to thank you, Ms. S and Ms. L. And thank you all teachers. I appreciate you. Bye.
The teacher that I am thankful for is Mrs. Fowler. She's always very caring and pushes me to my limits and is always smiling.
You're the best teacher ever, Mr. Mickelson. I miss you.
Hi, my name is Taylor, and I go to Abraham Lincoln Elementary, and my teacher is Mr. Allman, and I miss all my friends.
Hi, Mrs. Abbott. Thanks for being my teacher. I really, really miss you.
Mrs. Carson, I thank you for everything that you do. I miss you. Thank you.
Allison, I miss you a lot. I can't wait to see you. Bye.
Hi, Miss Alderman. I appreciate you because you work so hard for our class to take care of us. And I miss you.
I miss Allison for being my teacher.